Welcome back to the Azure Cosmos DB Essential Series. My name is Mustafa. I am the Portfolio PMM for Azure Cosmos DB. And this season, we're joined by Mark Brown, a PM on the Azure Cosmos DB product team. This season, we want to take use cases a step further and dive into some of the architectures customers are using to build lightweight applications. Today, we're going to talk about one of the major use cases for NoSQL, building out a product catalog.
So to share a little bit about why customers use Azure Cosmos DB for this use case, let's talk about some of the needs that e-commerce customers have. One is the need to have a product catalog. A typical product catalog is filled with items that all have vastly different product attributes and variants. Each of these has different names and different values and different data types. Maybe I want to sell, say balloons or coffee cups, and maybe vegetables. Each of these things is so different from the other, it would be impossible to design a database with a schema that would work for all of them and handle that variety. You might also make different products available in different regions. And then once we get that in front of the right people, we need to make sure we have high availability so that we can serve everyone visiting the web app quickly and without downtime. The other use case customers have that I want to touch on is the need to store state for users on their site. Taking into account the current expectations around user experience, people visiting the site would expect that I can open this site on my computer, add some products to my shopping cart, then maybe close my browser, log in on my phone later, and then have my shopping cart contents right there. This is actually fairly easy to accomplish with Azure Cosmos DB because Cosmos DB is designed for extreme low latency, which makes it really great as a cache. To make this even easier, .NET developers can use the session state and cache provider available via NuGet that seamlessly integrates into ASP.NET web applications and uses Cosmos DB as a fast cache and session state store for users. Taken together, for developers looking to build retail or e-commerce applications, Cosmos DB provides flexible schema to allow us to represent diverse entities in a single container. It's also super fast, which makes it great for user session state or as a general key value store in an application cache. And because Cosmos DB has built-in replication and can easily replicate data into every region within Azure, this means that developers can build their e-commerce applications and deploy them in multiple regions, providing both higher availability and higher performance for users where data is replicated more closely to them.
Okay, so let's start to dig into some of the details here. When I'm browsing a website, I'd say my behavior is going to be pretty standard. I'm going to log in, search for a few things, filter through results, and eventually add it to my cart and forget about it. Talk us through some of the pieces here that make that possible.
Okay, so for most e-commerce web applications, there are essentially three places you'll want to store data. You'll have a cold or blob store, a transactional store like Cosmos DB, and then an application cache. The blob store is where you would put things like product images or other large static content that doesn't make sense to store in a transactional database. In the transactional database, we'll have all of our other product data and customer data, including orders. And we'll also use it to provide a persistent storage for our session state. Then in our cache, we'll have all sorts of things to improve the performance and manage state itself.
So walk us through how we might structure our Cosmos DB database in this architecture.
Right. So there are a number of different containers in here that we would use. The important data would be my customer and order data, which I'd store in a single container partitioned by customer ID. Second, I'd have my product catalog. And this would have a document for each product with all the data I need to render that product page for the user, including one or more URLs that would then point to any of the images I want to render on that page. And those URLs would basically point to blob storage where I'd have those actual images saved. As I pointed out earlier, Cosmos DB is schema agnostic. Now, if I'm selling laptops and coffee cups on this site, coffee cups obviously would have a value for things like liquid ounces, a color, and maybe a material like metal or plastic. Laptops have attributes like CPU, RAM, SSD, or hard disk capacity, etc. So schema for storing these products as documents is going to relieve a lot of headaches as we start to add more and more products to our catalog. The other container I want to call out here is the one we'd use to store the session state for the users. In this application, we'll use the ASP.NET session state provider and use Cosmos as the underlying data store. We could use it to store all of our cache data, such as product pages or anything else that would reduce the number of trips to the database. But in our scenario here, what we really need is to use the session state to store the contents of the user's shopping cart and then persist that into Cosmos DB. This allows users to log in via some other means, like a mobile device or some other app, where they'd likely hit a completely different set of app servers, so they can access the contents of their shopping cart and anything else related to the session and basically just pick up from where they left off.
So I also wanted to cover a pretty crucial user experience piece for most e-commerce applications, and that's called search, right? How do we go about creating that search filtering aspect?
Typically, we'll use something like Azure Cognitive Search. Users can configure search to index one or more containers in their database. Then, when a user types in some text and clicks search, the request is sent to Cognitive Search, which then returns the results, which can then be rendered as a search results page, each pointing to an individual product, such that when a user clicks on that, they are then directed to an individual product page to view the results. A developer would build out the search results page and, of course, their own product pages. But Cognitive Search will give us everything we need to crawl through and present relevant search results to users.
So that's actually pretty simple. Sure, there are some moving parts maybe that we won't cover here because I think that gives a pretty good idea of how we get started if I wanted to build something like this on my own. But I wanted to revisit this idea of caching, right? Cosmos DB has an integrated cache. What's the difference between that cache and using a container as a backup store for the session state provider and cache you mentioned earlier?
Right. So the main goal of the integrated cache is to reduce cost and latency for read-heavy workloads for queries, which are exceptionally large and expensive. You should only consider integrated cache if you have repeated point reads on large items, or if you have high volume of queries that span multiple partitions, or are even fan-out queries, as well as scenarios where you have, say, a hot partition key for your reads. Integrated cache can both increase the performance for your applications, but it can also provide considerable cost savings where there are issues with partition strategy in your queries.
Awesome. Well, I think that wraps up the second episode of season 3. Join us in the next episode where we're going to do the same thing for an order processing solution built with Azure Cosmos DB and Azure Functions. We hope you learned something. See you next time.